I'm going to put this title down. Scriptures, what does scripture say to teach men? I'm dealing with the Brent men first. What does it mean to become a man? How do we become men in this truth? Give me, let's open it with, who's reading for me?
Officer Liam, Shalom Bishop.
Hey, Shalom. 2 Timothy 2:15. 2 Timothy 2 and 15. What does it mean to be a man? How do we become men? Let's see one of the first things we got to do. Read that.
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
Study. So as men, we must study. Study to show ourselves approved. Notice it says unto God. A lot of you like to say, I don't please no man, I please God. But guess what? When you please God, you're pleasing the men around you. Everybody understand that? That's why it says study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed. Ashamed before who? Before men. You won't be ashamed. Why? Because by pleasing God, studying, you will not be ashamed, and everyone will understand that this man right here serves the Lord. Okay? Right? Read on.
Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
Rightly dividing the word of truth. Give me Ecclesiastes 12, 13. Ecclesiastes 12 and 13. Oh, I forgot to say shalom to the brothers and sisters online. I pray all is well. Pray all is... Oh, and shalom haters. Hi, haters. How can I forget about you?
The book of Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments.
Fear God and keep his commandments. Come on.
For this is the whole duty of man.
That's the whole duty of man. That's what the entire Bible is about from Genesis on up. Fearing God and keeping his commandments. Churches ain't understand that thing to this day. They don't get it. Okay. Give me 1 Kings 2:13.
Kings chapter 2, verse 13. And Adonijah, the son of Haggith, came
I'm
to...
Sorry, 1 to 3. I apologize. 1 Kings chapter 2, 1 to 3. I apologize.
Yes, sir. 1 Kings chapter 2, verse 1. Now the days of David drew nigh that he should die.
So David, King David, was about to die. Come on.
And he charged Solomon, his son, saying, I go the way of all the earth. Be thou strong, therefore, and show thyself a man.
He told Solomon on his deathbed, be thou strong, therefore, and show thyself a man. That's the discussion I'm having with you men right now. Be strong and show yourself a man. What does it mean? Read.
And keep the charge of the Lord thy God.
That's what a lot of men are missing right there. Keeping the charge of the Lord our God. This is why you got a lot of baby daddies out there. That's why you got a lot of people are males, but they're not men that God has chosen. Okay, read.
To walk in his ways.
To walk in his ways. Come on.
To keep his statutes and his commandments.
To keep his statutes and his commandments.
And his judgments.
And his judgments.
And his testimonies.
And his testimonies.
As it is written in the law of Moses.
As it is written in the law of Moses.
That thou mayest prosper in all that thou doest.
That thou mayest prosper in all that thou doest, whithersoever thou turnest thyself. So from there, give me Revelation 14, 12. This is for the Christians online. Because it says that right there, but it don't say it in the New Testament. Yes, it does, O Christian. Yes, it does, you hypocrites.
Revelation 14 and 12. Here is the patience of the saints.
Here is the patience of the saints. The saints are the Israelites.
Here are they that keep the commandments of God.
That's the same thing David told Solomon. Keep the commandments of God.
And the faith of Jesus.
And the faith of Jesus. That goes with the testimonies, okay? From there, give me 2 Samuel 19:24. Listen good, man. Listen good. So this is the beginning of manhood right there. That's what you're supposed to be teaching your sons right there. Come on.
2 Samuel 19 and 24. And Mephibosheth.
Mephibosheth was a descendant of Saul, King Saul.
The son of Saul.
Son of Saul.
Came down to meet the king.
Mm-hmm.
And had neither dressed his feet.
He didn't put shoes on and washed his feet. He didn't do it. Come on.
Nor trimmed his beard.
And he didn't trim his beard. Some of y'all think it's a sin to trim your beard. You look unkempt. Can you look that word up for us? Google it. Unkempt. UNKEMPT, I believe. You know I can't spell, but I think that's how it go. Unkempt. Put it on the screen. Yep, let's see what it means. Read that.
Unkempt. Especially of a person having an untidy or disheveled appearance.
Disheveled
appearance. Untidy, messy, scruffy, disordered, disheveled, disarranged, rumpled, windblown, bedraggled, in a mess, messed up, shabby, slovenly, shaggy, tussled, uncombed, knotted.
Uncombed. Matted. Some of y'all think it's a sin to comb your hair. It's not a sin to look nice, brothers. You coming to the truth looking like a hobos.
Hey, Bishop, you believe everything you just mentioned there, everything you just mentioned, me, Captain Zeph, Deacon Laba, we all was in front early on today. This brother came up inside, his shirt was back to front, his hair and coat wrinkle, his hair and comb. He got an afro in his. I like, bro, what's wrong with you, man? I said, how can you put on your how old are you, 22? I said, how can you put on your shirt back to front, man? We had to take him in the bathroom. I said, yo, go comb your hair.
Wow.
And do that's what's early on today.
And he wanna get married.
Yeah.
And one of them gonna lay down with him probably. Bum brothers bring forth bum kids. I always remember that. So, brothers, don't be a bum. Read that again, Officer Leon.
Yes, sir.
2 Samuel.
And Mephibosheth, the son of Saul, mm-hmm. came down to meet the king and had neither dressed his feet
mm-hmm.
nor trimmed his beard
mm-hmm.
nor washed his clothes.
Nor washed his clothes. What the hell is this? Come on.
From the day the king departed until the day he came again in peace.
So he was looking like a bum. We cannot Mephibosheth, brothers. That's the new term. He's being a Mephibosheth over there. Sisters, don't name your son Mephibosheth, please. Give me a 2 Thessalonians 3:10. So tidiness, groom yourself. Look nice. Brush your teeth. Comb your hair. These are things your daddy should have taught you. Wash. We're going to get into that a little later on. Give me that second. Some people brothers be stinking. Read that. Come on. 2 Thessalonians 3:10.
Yes, sir. 2 Thessalonians 3:10.
Remember, we're talking about being men. Yes, go ahead.
For even when we were with you,
uh-huh.
this we commanded you, that if any would not work, neither should he eat.
If you don't work, you don't eat. You don't work, you don't. We read New Testament, brothers. I know some of you might be Christians. You don't say it in the New Testament. We read in the New Testament. If you don't work, you don't eat. And let me tell you something in case somebody gets stupid. I remember we had a brother who dealt in stocks, and he did motivational speaking. Y'all know who I'm talking about? Brother was wealthy, millionaire, became a millionaire. He left a long time ago, but he was with us. And so he didn't have a 9-to-5. Brothers got mad and pulled that scripture on him. I said, what the hell is wrong with y'all? He has worked. He invested his money. This is talking about bum brothers. That's what this verse. Read it again for the simple brother.
For even when we were with you, this we commanded you,
mm-hmm.
that if any would not work,
neither
should he eat.
Uh-huh, go ahead.
For we hear that there are some which walk among you disorderly.
That's the problem. These dudes that weren't working were disorderly. Go ahead.
Working not at all. But are busybodies.
But are in everybody's business. Was that it, Officer Leon?
Yes, sir.
So Paul said, get work. What the hell is wrong with you men? Okay. So now from there, give me Sirach 7:15. In the Apocrypha, Ecclesiasticus. Ecclesiasticus 7 and 15.
Sirach chapter 7 and verse 15, or Ecclesiasticus. Hate not laborious work.
You hear that, brothers? Hate not laborious work. Go ahead.
Neither husbandry.
Neither farming. That's what husbandry is. Neither farming. Go ahead.
Which the Most High hath ordained.
Who ordained it?
Which the Most High hath ordained.
From the time of Adam, the Lord ordained working workmanship. He ordained husbandry. He ordained laborious work. That was one of the penalties that came upon Adam, okay, for listening to his wife. Adam didn't have to work, but because of him listening to the wife, the Most High said, for this, you're going to have to till the ground. You're going to have to work all through the sweat of your brow all the days of your life, okay? From there, Ecclesiastes 29 and 21 down. We're still dealing with being men, so I hope y'all putting like little highlights next to it and see if you fit what we're reading or not.
Ecclesiastes.
There's a little self-examination. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. Ecclesiastes chapter 29 and verse 21.
I know we want to talk about great mysteries, the white man's the devil, destruction of Babylon. Not today. Not today. Bible's a big book. Go ahead.
The chief thing for life is water.
The chief thing for life is water, brothers. Go ahead.
And bread.
And bread.
Clothing.
And clothing.
And a house to cover shame.
And a house to cover shame. Should nobody up in there be homeless? Read.
Better is the life of a poor man in a mean cottage.
Better is the life of a poor man in a mean, jacked up place. Go ahead.
Than delicate fare in another man's house.
Than living luxurious in another man's house. Mm. I want you, man. Can you read the verse again?
Yes, sir. Better is the life of a poor man in a mean cottage than delicate fare in another man's house.
Get your own, brothers. Get your own. Don't be living in another man's house. Come on. You can't have two lions in the house. Let me tell you right now. There's something gonna go wrong in there. Okay, because you're going to have ways that he don't like. He going to have ways that it's going to start to annoy you, too. Go ahead.
Be it little or much, hold thee content.
Be it little. What verse you at?
Verse 23.
Read it again.
Be it little or much, hold thee content.
So whether or not you have a little or you have a lot, be content with what you have. That don't mean you can't improve. But what status you're at right now, be content where you're at. That way it will not lead you to steal, to lie, to destroy. That's what content means. It prevents you from stealing, lying, and harming others. That's what it goes into. Read that again.
Be it little or much, hold thee contented, that thou hear not the reproach of thy house.
Right, because it's yours. You got a place to stay. You paid for it. It's yours. Go ahead.
For it is a miserable life to go from house to house.
Read that part again. I want you brothers to listen good. Come on.
For it is a miserable life to go from house to house.
We have met some brothers that go from house to house to house. Have no certain dwelling. That is the life of a bum. Read it again, that part.
For it is a miserable life to go from house to house.
Now, if you're a man of wisdom that know the scriptures, you're going to realize this is a miserable life I have. I don't have my own place. Why? Because you don't like to work. Okay, you can't keep a job. So you, brother, can I stay with you this month? The next time, brother, can I stay with you next month? Then you're asking Deacon Lyle, can I stay with you? That's a miserable life. Then that brother has the audacity to say, I want to get married. I want a wife. And who are they going to live with, him? They going to live with the brother next door to you? The hell is this? Go ahead.
For where thou art a stranger, thou darest not open thy mouth.
When you're a stranger living in somebody else's house, you dare not open your mouth. Go ahead.
Thou shalt entertain.
You're going to help entertain people.
And feast.
You're going to help feast with people.
And have no thanks.
And ain't nobody going to thank you because it ain't your place. Go ahead.
Moreover, thou shalt hear bitter words.
Let's see what bitter words you're going to hear soon. Go ahead.
Come thou stranger and furnish a table.
Hey, bro, come over here and fix the table. Fix the table for my guests. Go ahead.
And feed me.
And feed me.
Of that thou hast ready.
Of what thou hast ready. Go ahead.
Give place, thou stranger, to an honorable man.
Hey, give place, thou stranger. I got an honorable man coming. So I'm going to need that place you staying in. You're going to have to leave. Go ahead.
My brother cometh to be lodged.
My brother comes to be lodged.
And I have need of mine house.
I need my whole house. I need you to get out.
These things are grievous to a man of understanding.
See that? These things are grievous to a man of understanding. That's why I started off with 2 Timothy 2:15. But if you a bum, you gonna be, ain't nothing wrong. What I do? You put me out unrighteously. That's what you hear. No, get out. Read it again.
These things are grievous to a man of understanding. The upbraiding of house room and reproaching of the lender.
From there, give me Matthew 19:5. You mentioned marriage. we mention marriage.
Matthew chapter 19 and verse 5. And said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother.
Man shall leave father and mother.
And shall cleave to his wife.
Cleave to, that's talking about marriage. This is the law of marriage Christ is quoting. Go ahead.
And they twain shall be one flesh.
In order to cleave to a wife, where are you going to put her? In your friend's house? In your mama house? In your, it said, read it again, case we missed it.
And they twain.
No, read the whole verse again.
And said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother.
Brothers, you must leave your father and your mother. Go ahead.
And shall cleave to his wife.
And you got to take your wife to you. Go ahead.
And they twain.
And you too.
Shall be one flesh.
One flesh of one mind. 1 Corinthians 7 and 2, please. 1 Corinthians 7 and 2.
1 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 2. Nevertheless, to avoid fornication.
To avoid sexual sins.
Let every man have his own wife.
Let every man have his own wife.
And let every woman.
And let every woman.
Have her own husband.
Have her own husband. There's no sharing. That every, look what it says. And this is why a lot of brothers, if you notice in the Israelite community, they're starting to say we reject the writings of Paul because it offends our polygamy, our polygamous intentions. Not even polygamous. Lust. Read it again, verse 2.
Nevertheless, to avoid fornication, let every man have his own wife. And let
every woman
have her own husband.
Does it say multiple? They all share in one man? No. Every woman have her own. Understand the English language. You ain't got to go deep into the Greek or the Hebrew. Let every woman have her own husband. We're going to go into more depth into that. Now, how do you know whether or not you're a bum or not? We went over the criteria of what a man is, but let's talk about being a bum. Canada, pay attention. I don't know what you're doing over there. I want you to pull up TLC, please. This is a group back in the 90s. I just want the first 33 seconds. The first, all 33 seconds. People always insult men. Read that. I mean, not read that. I mean, play that. Sorry. All I want is the first 33 seconds so they don't cut us off. Huh? 27 is the cutoff? Okay. So start at 3 seconds. Start at 5 seconds. Start at 5 seconds. No scrubs. That's in the. How many of y'all know this song? Oh, okay. Go ahead, play that. I don't hear nothing. Skip ahead a little bit. Lacey Slide is also known as a buster. Always talking about what he wants and just sits on his broke ass. Pretend to sit on your butt. No, I don't want your number. I give you mine and I ain't giving you mine. I wanna meet you nowhere now. I wanna live time. Put my name on the city because I own it if they let me. Was that it? Come on, Canada. How come New York is always...
No, that's 27 seconds.
That was 27 seconds? I didn't hear the... Did they say no scrubs? Did y'all hear that part? Okay, I wanted to hear more, but okay. Give me... Okay, now, right there. This song, I don't want no scrubs. That's what they women say, but somebody... Come on, y'all. New York. Give me the next one. You're just messing up my train of thought over there. Give me the next one, Gwen. I want Gwen. Gwen Guthrie. Bill Collectors at my door. That one. Y'all know, how many of y'all know that song? That was women's anthem. Okay. I want, hey, to Canada. Start at 1 minute and 2 seconds. You could put the disclaimer up there. That ain't gonna work. Okay, enough music. Okay, you got it? 102? Play, this is Gwen Guthrie. Go ahead. Come on, Canada. Dad, go on. You got to have a play on me if you want to be with me. Ain't nothing going on the roof. You got to have a play on me if you want to be with me. No romance is the finest. That's all I want. That's all I want. See, women know that song right there. See, that was an older generation, but this newer generation, these millennials, they taking brothers with no jobs, no place to live, and they're having babies. Then they're going on TV talking about people being messed up. But sister, you spread eagle over there. You, y'all see the men, you know what spread eagle is. Hey, give me Kevin Samuels about washing. Watch the other side of the room. A lot of times, like I said, we just start off with the men just for a moment. Start off with the men. A lot of sisters hate his guts. But before he got on sisters, he got on the men for 3 years. 3 years. And they had nothing to say. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Until he flipped the switch on them. Then the bottom lip stuck out, dragged the floor. Neck started moving side to side. They put a hit on him and had that woman. She might have put him to death. I don't know. But she was good looking. But anyway. Go ahead. Come on now. Listen good, brothers. Come on, Canada.
These are Equate flushable wipes. What are these for? Wipe your ass, niggas. Stop wiping your ass with paper, with toilet tissue. These need to sit right behind your toilet. And after you take a shit, you wipe until the brown is gone. And yes, you also need to put your middle finger up and around your bunghole a little bit, nigga. Don't freak your shit now. You get no good stupid. But you need to make sure you clean out to where you don't want no fucking dingleberries, man. And you cannot wipe yourself clean enough with toilet tissue. Leave these in your bathroom. Bitches will appreciate it. Niggas will appreciate it. Wipe your ass with these and then dry off with paper towel, with toilet paper. These are...
That was it. So... Bro, and there's a reason I played that video, because we get emails about sisters saying, married sisters, how brothers have dingleberries down there and want the sister to go downstairs on them. And they're like, she ain't going down there, you got dingleberries. What the hell is wrong with you? Wash! Don't Mephibosheth, brothers. You nasty son of, excuse me. Give me the article that the angry black woman wrote. I want an article. There's an article the angry sister put. Yep, right there. We want to go through this. Her name is Faye Bishop. Go raise it up. Raise it up. Lower down. No, raise it up. It was right. Read that, Officer Leon.
Yes, sir. 12 signs that you may be dating a bum.
12 signs that you may be dating a bum. Now, there's something wrong with that sentence in itself.
Yeah.
Shouldn't you figure, see, they ain't figured out. They're like, what's wrong with that sentence? Everything's wrong with it. You should know he's a bum before you started dating him. See, I didn't know. What's wrong with me? Yeah, everything's wrong with you. You're getting a quote-unquote relationship, which is really whoredom. You're laying down with him. You have sex with him. Then you say, can you take me by your place? He take you to his mama house in a basement. Raise it up so we can read it.
Do not assume.
No. I want to just get to the point.
Okay.
Let's start right there. Lower it right there. Below are 12 signs.
Yes, sir. Below are 12 signs to help you detect whether or not you are dating one of these parasitic blood suckers.
Parasitic blood. This is an angry. See, she must have got burned many, many a time. Mm-hmm. I can't blame her. So she wrote this article, which I found very funny. She called bum brothers parasitic blood suckers. Mm. Some of these sisters in here is with parasitic blood suckers. Let's read the first one.
Forms attachment fast.
So the blood-sucking brother will form an attachment fast. What you mean by that?
Bums tend to have a very shallow relationships.
Bums tend to have a very shallow relationship.
Mm-hmm. And this can lead to women being impressed by their eagerness to tell you they love you.
Yeah, woman, I tell you love me. They said Halle Berry used to like that too. Tell me you love me. Am I beautiful? Go ahead.
And talks of marriage and commitment.
Right. She ain't even find out his financial status, where he live, his education. She ain't find nothing. She just want to hear I love you. And a bum know that. He going to say that. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Do not be fooled. It's all game.
It's all, sisters, it's all game. When you hear a brother say he love you, it's game. Mm. Chances are he's a bum and he just need a place to stay. Go ahead.
The bum is.
Sorry if I'm blowing some of y'all spot up in here. Some of you men might hate my guts right now because this is describing you.
Right, Bishop, real men does not, you just talking to a woman, you already telling her, I love you. Mm-hmm. And I be cursing some of you brothers up out inside there that be doing that stuff. You know how much of these brothers be telling sisters they love them and they've been talking for a couple months?
Wow.
I'm like, yo, don't be telling these sisters, you talking for a couple months, you already telling her you love her. Women don't like that, brother. You know, what is showing that you a simp, bro? You don't do that, you know what I mean? Wait till marriage or something, you know?
Read on.
The bum isn't really committed.
The bum isn't really committed, sister. Go ahead.
This kind of talk is done deliberately to throw you in a head spin of.
Oh, he loved me. He loved me, girl. He said he loved me. Go ahead.
To throw you in a head spin of confusion as it positions you exactly where they want you to be, at their every beck and call.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Borrows money.
Oh, that's number two, sisters. He borrows. Soon as he meets you. Within a month or two, he's borrowing your money. See, they're getting quiet now because some of them know they got a bum.
Damn.
Go ahead.
It starts with a few bucks and promises to pay you back.
I'll pay you back. Let me $25.
Mm-hmm. Pretty soon, the borrowing becomes habit.
Becomes habit, sisters. Uh-huh.
And you never see the money in return.
You never see that money again. Go ahead.
Cheapskates are bad.
Cheapskates? I remember that back when I was a kid. Cheapskates. Mm-hmm. You ever heard that term, Lava? She from Haiti, but that was a popular term when we was kids. Go ahead.
Cheapskates are bad. Freeloaders are worse.
Freeloaders are worse. Go ahead.
You know he could contribute.
That, you hear women say this all the time. You know he could contribute. Go ahead.
But he's selfish and has an out of whack sense of entitlement. He's a bum.
He's a bum, sisters. So that's number two. Now let's read the third one.
Constantly gives excuses.
Uh-oh, so a bum constantly gives excuses. Go ahead.
Losers give excuses.
Losers give excuses. Go ahead.
Winners make things happen.
Mm-hmm.
If he is constantly giving excuse after excuse as to why he can't stay employed.
Right, they get a job every 2 months. He get a different job because he keep getting fired or he quits. Go ahead.
Isn't in school.
Remember the brother that was with us? He would get a new job every 6 months. He makes sure he could get to unemployment. He quit the job, didn't stay out of work for like a year, however it lasts. Then he get another job, kept your unemployment with the. He's a bum. Move from house to house. Go ahead.
As to why he can't stay employed. Isn't mm-hmm. in school, doesn't have money, has a bad temper, or why he becomes violent when you refuse to give into his needs. He's a bum.
Sisters, he's a bum. That's why he's always angry. He ain't got no money, and he's angry when you don't give him no money. He's a bum. Go ahead.
Next point. Lives with his mother, aunt, grandma, best friend,
etc. Let me ask a question, brothers. How many of you he live with your mama? Raise your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay.
Yeah, Levi, brothers, put your hand up.
Daggone. Wow.
Hey, Levi is like 45 years old, too.
Oh. Man, you blew my man's spot up, bro. Dag. Well, let's read that part again.
Lives with his mother,
uh-huh.
auntie, grandmother, best friend, etc.
Now, I do have to put a, is this the word stipulation? Is that the word? Levi is a different tribe. They keep their children at home till like, they old. I'm like, bro, why are you still at home? He goes, this is what Levi does. His mother didn't want him. Don't leave the house. Stay, supposed. Mommy, I want to get married and leave. No. Get the breast milk. drink. When Captain Isaac got married, how old was he? 30, 35? I said, Cap, you 35, you still at home? He said, I'm still at home. My mother won't let me leave. I said, you got money in the bank now. He had cheddar all in the bank. He said, I got enough to get married. He said, I got to wait till I find a wife. That's when he met Sister Yoella. All praises. Yes. See, Levi is different. Oh, yeah. You get married, Levi, she said, bring the wife to live here. You come here, live here. So that's different. They different. Judah say, get out when you 15.
16.
Just get out. Go. Go. Dag. I don't know about Benjamin. What y'all do? Y'all throw them out when they're young? Or y'all just leave?
I just left.
You just left?
Yeah, Bishop, Demi, you answered my question for Judah.
Oh, yeah. They throw us out early.
Get out. I always just wonder why I don't sound like that.
So, read that again, Osilio.
Lives with his mother, aunt, grandmother, best friends, etc.
Right. So now, this sometimes happens when men fall on child support, hard times. They got to go right back to mama's house. I'm not talking about Levi. I'm talking about all the other tribes. Go ahead.
This isn't a necessarily deal breaker for some, but it is definitely something worth examining.
It's not a deal breaker because sometimes brothers have saved money to waiting to get a wife. So you got to check that out. Go ahead.
Personal economic downturns are usually temporary, not permanent. If he has a basement room completely set up where he pursues his personal interests such as music, computers, porn, lifting weights, yeah, this dude has set up house. He isn't going nowhere anytime soon unless it's to your house to live off of you. He's a bum.
He's a bum. Go ahead.
Hits the panic button at sign of a breakup. Mm. Bums tend to panic at the thought of you cutting them off.
No more money, no more food, no more sex. Go ahead.
Unless it's their idea.
No more shelter. Go ahead. And then unless it's their idea. Go ahead.
And then you're dropped like a hot rock.
And you're dropped like a hot rock. Come on.
They will break down and cry, plead, promise to change, offer gifts.
I'll get a job, my brother. I'll get a job. Go ahead.
Even threaten with suicide.
Oh, sisters, when they threaten you with suicide, you better run. I'll kill myself if you don't keep me. Oh, man. That's what a sign of abuse right there. Go ahead.
It's all game to play on your emotions. And it's done to throw you into a guilt trip where you are then thrusted into multitudes of emotions. Example, blaming yourself, feeling that you are the problem, etc.
Right. It's not that he's a bum and he got dingleberries. No, it's not that. Mm-hmm. It's you. Go ahead.
Paranoid control. Mm-hmm. Bums can be very controlling, which has to do with their feelings of inadequacy.
He ain't right. Go ahead.
They will encourage you to drop your hobbies.
Drop your hobbies, sisters. Go ahead.
Interests.
Drop all your interests. Go ahead.
And involvement with others.
Uh-huh.
Yes, even your friends and family.
Cut everybody off. They isolate you. Go ahead.
The idea behind this is to prevent you from doing anything other than engaging in activities which they totally control.
You got to watch out for the paranoid control. I just want to talk about that just for a moment. The paranoid control. Sisters, when you get married, beware of the brothers that want you to give him all your money. Be mindful of that. Now, he's the head of the house. He could do that. But then some men, I'm not saying all men, some men, like this one brother I know, had a gambling problem and almost lost his house gambling. The wife was furious. Lost his car. Yeah, that's why he always wanted the wife's money. Give me your money. Be mindful of that. And remember, the bum don't work, but he's very controlling. He wants all what you have. He removes you from doing your hobbies, your interests. If you have a business, quit. You know, involvement with others. Yes, even your friends and family. Why? So you have no place to go when he gets irate. You are stuck under his dingleberries. Who want to be stunk under that? The hell is this? Hey, very mindful.
Bishop, another one they'll do is, they'll say, look, you can give me the money when you want money. I'll give it to you. You know I'm not going to hold it back from you. But if she spends $20, he says, tell me what you spend the $20 on. Okay? You got those? I want receipts. I want to know what you spend the money on. Anything she spends money on, she has to show it. Okay, that's another form of control. Yeah. If you're giving him all the money, but then when you go to buy something, he says, show me what you bought. And he'll fight you until you show him what you bought. That's control.
Yep, paranoid control. And how many of y'all got daughters in here? Raise your hand. Raise your daughters. Okay, now I'm going to help you brothers out. Because some brothers get the devil on. You got daughters?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We've had cases here where brothers married a sister. Then and he was seemed all right. Then he turned into a nigger. I'm sorry for using the word, but it makes my teeth white. He turned into a nigger and was very controlling and isolated the sister from everything. Then he dropped her like a, he just woke up and left. She had the baby. She had no job, nothing. Okay. Make sure with your daughters, especially, open a bank account for your daughter. Have her name on it and your name. So the Negro can't get his little dirty, black, ashy hands in the account. I'm telling y'all. Because that's what some of them will do. They will take everything, isolate her, cut her off from you. Okay, be very mindful. A nigger got many evil ways about him. He'll move out of state because you want to bust hot brass in him, but you can't because he's so far away. So make sure you open an account in her name, put your name on it as well, so he can't put his, give me access to the account. No, that's my daddy account. Damn. Now you might think I'm being mean, but I'm just trying to help you. I'm trying to help me help you.
Right, that's just a plan B, just in case that brother turn into a nigga.
That's right.
That's just a plan B. We ain't telling sisters to usurp authority over their husband. None of, that's just a plan B because we see it happen. Mm-hmm. We see brothers deal evil with sisters, marry them, and down the line they change, you know? And that's just a plan B for just in case, man. Just in case. You know what I mean?
Hey, how many of y'all saw? There's a lot of movies like that. You got, what's the one with Blair? I always ask the movie name. I always get it wrong.
Madea's Family Reunion.
Family, is that the one with Blair Underwood?
Yes.
When he's beating the crap out of the sister? Yes. Man, shoot, that's a good movie. And the one with the white woman, Sleeping with the Enemy. Yep, that's a good one. She had to fake her death to get away from this dude because he was beating the crap out of her. She had to have a secret account and all that just so she could get a life for her and her daughter. This dude was crazy. So it goes back to this.
Yeah, Bishop, but yeah.
This is Israel. Everybody's righteous.
Really?
Okay. Yeah. You know, Bishop, we come to the truth. We expect, you know, everybody's righteous. Brothers is spiritual. Mm-hmm. Sisters is spiritual. We all holy up inside here.
Yeah, okay. Woo, you ain't nobody laughing, right, Dylan? Everybody mad quiet. Read the next one.
If he's a deadbeat father.
You know what? Sisters never ask that question. Do you have kids? And if he has kids, does he take care of those kids? How many of y'all have children and you're not married? You just got kids. Raise your hand. Okay, 4, 5, 6, 7. Some brothers got a halfway raise. Okay, about 8 brothers. Okay. They're not sure if the kids are theirs. You better get a DNA test. Yeah, 8 and a half brothers had their hands like this. I'm not sure if that's mine. Get a DNA test. So read that again, Officer Leon.
If he's a deadbeat father, this is self-explanatory.
Mm-hmm.
Do not assume that he will be any different if you have a baby for him.
Right, if he ain't taking kid over here, he ain't going to take care of yours. Now, I'm not saying men can't change because I've seen wonders. I've seen brothers change. So there is a possibility. But you better check it out first, sis. Examine him. Go ahead.
If he abuses alcohol and drugs, he's a bum.
If he abuses alcohol and drugs, he is a bum. Some of you brothers don't need to drink. Don't need to drink. Stop the weed. Stop the drugs altogether. Now, we know it's lawful to drink alcohol, but if you got to know your limit. Everybody has a limit. You see, Deacon Asaph don't drink at all. He's one of them angry drunks. Get drunk, you want to fight everybody. I can beat you. I can beat you. I'll fight everybody. Don't drink.
Hey, Bishop,
and
if you can't go one day without a drink, you're an alcoholic.
Exactly.
Okay, I had a couple call, and the woman was saying, ask him how many days he goes without drinks. He drinks 7 days a week. And because he doesn't look inebriated, he says he don't got a problem. So I told him, just only on the Sabbath, don't drink. And he left out of here. He said, you trying to control me, brother. He left.
Wow. Hey, remember we had the brother drinking Matt? I forgot the name of the little alcohol, but he started crying. Fireball. You get some brothers that cry when they drink, when they get drunk. Well, what the hell's wrong? He drunk. He got the bottle in his hand, just crying. Then start talking to little 13-year-old girls at the Feast of Pentecost. Thank you. I love you. Bro, she's 13. Get the hell away from her. We had to throw him out. The hell is this? Thank God he's gone. Anyway, where we at next?
Spins.
Oh, you know when you get drunk, your little pervert spirit will come out. It's going to come out. You ain't going to. That's why they call it spirits.
Courage, Jesus.
And if you fighting that homo spirit and you get drunk, oh, it's going to come out. You're going to start ass smacking. Bro, what the hell is wrong with you? Slap ass. It's going to come out. Just get a little tipsy. It's going to come out. Where we at?
Spends his days texting, Facebooking.
Spends his days texting, Facebooking.
Playing video games.
Mm-hmm.
Eating and sleeping all day.
Bag! Eating and sleeping. Some of them married to this guy right now. Go ahead.
He's a bum,
sisters. Go ahead. Real men are productive individuals. Go ahead.
They will make themselves useful in any way they can. Not only to you, but themselves.
Right. So the first one they got to deal with is themselves. Man got to make sure he's dealing himself right. Then he could take time for you. If he ain't taking care of himself, sis, he ain't going to take care of you. What do you say? Say it on the mic.
Right. And the scripture says that. It says, which man you know don't love it himself?
Right. In Ephesians 5.
Yep.
Right.
And if you don't love yourself, you can't love nobody else.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Read on.
Constantly asking to borrow your car. He's a bum.
Grace.
If everything you do is never enough, he's a bum.
I'm not sure about that one right there, but come on, next one.
Lives in a constant state of drama.
Uh-oh.
Criminal record.
Uh-oh.
Bad credit.
Uh-oh. Well, I'll say this about bad credit, because I have bad credit, so I can speak on that one. And don't say it, don't smile, because my wife had bad credit too. We both had bad credit. We put our nickels and dimes together, fixed our little credit, got our little things here and there. You remember? Your wife was mad because you're like, yeah, I want a house. Everyone wanted a house. We would fix your credit. Fix your credit. Read that again.
Lives in a constant state of drama.
Yeah, go ahead.
Criminal record.
You better check a brother if he got a criminal record. Some of y'all be marrying brothers and they are,
sex offenders.
Sex offenders. Thank you. Sex offenders. You can't make the. We had a case. There was a case. Sister says, washing a daughter. Don't let nobody touch your poo-poo. The little girl, 8 years old. No, was she 8 or 6? I think she was 6. She said, Daddy always touch my poo-poo. What do you mean, Daddy touch your poo-poo? Yeah, Daddy always touch my poo-poo. Where? Show me. Down there. Turned out that the police came. The dude had a criminal background she knew nothing about. It's just simple. Damn. We're going to talk about that. They just, the handsome dude, she spread eagle. Whoa, look at him. He good looking. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Criminal record, bad credit, cries broke.
Mm-hmm.
Has a story for everything.
And he got a story for everything. He's in a constant state of drama. Go ahead.
It's irresponsible.
The dude is irresponsible, right?
And lies all the time for no reason at all.
Some of you know your man be lying and you just sit there and take it deep. Go ahead.
He's a bum.
He's a bum, sisters. He's a bum. Go ahead.
These are just a few warning signs to give you an idea of how to identify a bum and how to spot their loser behavior.
Mm.
Bums are like parasites or even worse, yeast infections.
A bum is like a yeast infection. Daggone. You know, a yeast infection smell like hell. It's all pussy and nasty. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about. You got one right now. Go ahead. Go ahead.
If you do not protect yourself against them, they will manifest and take over.
If you don't protect yourself against them, they will manifest and take over, sis. They're going to take your house, your place, your car. They're going to take everything. Go ahead.
I've watched some of the strongest, independent, self-sufficient women fall victim to good looks and a big penis. Only to find themselves left with an empty pocketbook, a broken heart, and tons of emotional baggage.
You know who's a good example of that? What's the Jamaican lady? No, the Jamaican dude married the late. She wrote a book. It's how Stella got her groove on. And she married the Jamaican brother. I forgot his name, but she said, oh, he's so handsome. She would, they went on TV shows. Then it turned out he's a homo. And he divorced her and took half of all. She was so damn mad. What was her name again? What was her name? McMillan. Terry McMillan. Terry McMillan. Thank you. Y'all could Google it. I ain't making it up. Terry McMillan. She was an Oprah and all that. She, her life, yeah, that's, she wrote that. Yep, Stella got her groove back. Terry, written by Terry. Hey, type in there with her husband. Terry McMillan and her husband. Terry McMillan. Miller is, I forgot. Millen. Right there, right there, right there. See it? Yep, that's him. When you see them eyes and them big lips like that, and that widow's peak, you better watch that. Look at that first picture. Hey, hey, girl.
Hey, Bishop, and he was a Jamaican?
Yes.
And he was a homo?
Yes.
I thought there were no homos in Jamaica.
Judges 19 tell you about
Yeah. You better check their history, bro.
You're your gully queens in Jamaica. Your gully queen, you nasty. They be living in the sewers talking about smell like perfume down here.
Yeah, the but Bishop, this? Bishop, she blind by that. That dude look.
He look crazy. But some of these sisters are so desperate for love. Dang-a-lang, dang-dang, dang-a-lang. So desperate, he must have laid it on her right. But she fell in love. And it wasn't right. Just wasn't right.
Yo, hey, yeah, Bishop, what we just saw, they says victim to good looks and big penis, right? Yeah. No, usually a bum brother could usually bum brothers, they usually got a lot of experience sexually because they home ain't doing nothing. All they do is, you know, that's like the peak of their game. They lay down right.
Right. Because they're giving you all they got. Yeah. He ain't got nothing else. He giving you everything.
So
you know what he call him? Write this word down. A hobo sexual. He's a bum, but he gives sex right. Oh yeah, I got that. That's coming. So she do backflips on that thing. So this sister that wrote this, she's already having sex, and no one read us Siraka 6 and 7, please. Sisters don't really like to apply this scripture right here because they're always the ones hurt, emotionally distraught.
Yes, sir. Ecclesiasticus or Sirach, chapter 6 and verse 7. If thou wouldest get a friend, prove him first, and be not hasty to credit him.
Mm-hmm. Be not hasty to credit him. Go ahead.
For some man is a friend for his own occasion.
Sisters, this is what we're reading about. Some men are friend for his own occasion. Like some sisters like to be pen pals to jailhouse brothers. Now, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with brothers that couldn't been to prison. A lot of brothers have been to prison. It's all right. But if they're telling you they love you and want to marry you and they're in prison and they've never met you, there's a problem. But these sisters are so desperate, so in love, so enamored, okay, because he lifts weights all day. Yeah. Them lifting weights is just keep a nigga off your ass muscles. That's all it is. Get off me, nigga! So sisters, you so desperate, you hook up with this dude. He just want a place to live when he get out. He already got another woman lined up that he met maybe a few days after he got to your place. He ain't really in love with you, but you fell for it. You fell for the okie doke.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.